now. If I'm not feeling any less sour, I promise myself to treat myself and visit a nearby tower. And climbing to the top will throw myself off in an effort to make clear to whoever what it's like when you're shattered, left standing in the lurch at a church where people are saying, my God, that's tough, she stood him up. No point in us remaining, we may as well go on as I did on my own, alone again. Naturally, to think that only yesterday I was cheerful, bright and gay, looking forward to what wouldn't do the role I was about to play. But as if to knock me down, reality came around, and without so much as a mere touch, cut me into little pieces, leaving me to doubt. Talk about God in His mercy, if He really does exist, why did He desert me in my hour of need? I truly am indeed alone again. It seems to me that there are more hearts broken in the world that can't be mended, left unattended. What do we do? What do we do? I remember I cried when my father died, never wishing to hide the tears. And at 65 years old, my mother, God rest her soul, couldn't understand why the only man she had ever loved had been taken, leaving her to start with a heart so badly broken. Despite encouragement from me, no words were ever spoken. She passed away, I cried and cried.